The COVID-19 pandemic is taking a toll on everyone. But for the Asian Australian community, a sharp increase in racism connected to the coronavirus is heaping on more stress. According to the Australian Human Rights Commission, around one in four people who've lodged a racial discrimination complaint in the last 2 months say they were targeted because of COVID-19.
Asian Australians are on the forefront as well. They are nurses, they are doctors, they are people in the essential services. They are there risking their lives as well.
It doesn't help that two of the country's most widely read newspapers have, at times, been a part of the problem, not to mention the leader of the free world.
I would like to begin by announcing some important developments in our war against the Chinese virus.
You feel suddenly that there's a divide in you, and there's almost a sense of loss of identity because you've been displaced. A home is no longer safe for you.
University of Notre Dame student Rachel Zhang has experienced a big change in the way people act around her.
When people look at you and try and move away from you, when people outrightly, you know, scream in your face like you're a bat eater or go home or go to your own country, go back to your home country.
Today, a group of prominent Chinese Australians worried about the growing division have written an open letter calling for unity.
COVID-19 has nothing to do with race or ethnicity or nationality. And while it's understandable that people are fearful in a time like this, there's no excuse for discrimination or racial conduct.
Absolutely. And author and journalist Benjamin Law was one of the prominent Chinese Australians who put their names to the open call for unity, and he joins us now. Ben, have you experienced racism in the last few weeks?
Look, Harry, I have to admit I'm one of the luckier ones, but I know friends and friends of friends who've all had their experiences. Where I am in the centre of Sydney, there have been news reports of people being spat on. And of course, we've probably all seen like social media reports disseminated about how Asians are stealing medical supplies or panic buying more than other people, which are completely unsubstantiated. But I've gotten a little bit on social media myself, I have to say.
Ben, what was the catalyst for you to write the letter?
I think the catalyst was seeing how it had started seeping out of just conspiracy theories and racist memes and into a lot more mainstream news reporting that apparently Asian Australians or Chinese people were stocking up on supplies they weren't supposed to. And often these came from reports that were completely unsubstantiated or came from unverified sources. And I think Australians have reached a boiling point. You know, we pride ourselves on not being a racist society, but when it's starting to really have these flashpoints where people are feeling and getting attacked properly in the streets, something kind of has to shift.
So obviously there are those kind of reports, but what do you think is actually driving this phenomenon?
Well, I think even before coronavirus really hit Australia, you might remember that there was this great paranoia about coronavirus being attached to Chinese people because, of course, it did start in China, but it meant that here in Australia, Chinatowns were being emptied out. We had to have campaigns about people actually going to Chinese restaurants, not being afraid. You can still get your local Chinese takeout, which you still can as well. But because there is this idea that there's this kind of foreign virus and therefore it's attached to foreign people or foreign-looking people, we've had that kind of paranoia take over to the point where, there are a few of us who have the heebie-jeebies, and that's not really necessarily legitimate.
Ben, talk us through what it's like to be on the receiving end of this kind of hate.
Well, me personally, I think the worst experience I've had was someone slipping into my replies on Twitter and saying, look, if it wasn't for you people eating bats, we wouldn't be in this situation. And I was like, whoa, that's a really intense thing to say. And also, how dare you? It was probably a pangolin. But I'm able to kind of joke about it merrily because I haven't, you know, had those situations where I've been confronted in the streets. I've probably had more subtle, less overt situations where back when you still could catch flights, people would be kind of shifting in their seats away from me more than they would from their non-Chinese Australian neighbours. So you get the sense that even just by looking the way that I do, or many of us do, that you're somehow contaminated.
Ben, are you and your Chinese Australian friends shocked or surprised at this? Like, when this story started to develop, was there a point where you got a sense of dread that this might be coming?
I think for many of us, there isn't necessarily an element of surprise because racism comes in waves and racism manifests in different ways. And I think Australians, when we talk about racism, we think, oh, OK, racism is when people say really awful slurs on public transport or when people are getting bashed in the streets. But racism really manifests in more subtle and less overt ways, like the sharing of unsubstantiated rumours that happen to be attached to people of a certain background. We felt it in the 90s with Pauline Hanson and One Nation Mark One. We're feeling it again now. And even though Chinese Australian people specifically have been in Australia for over 200 years and we have a history that in some ways predates white arrival, we are conspicuous, we do stand out, and there's always been a kind of a hostility that sometimes veers into racism against Chinese people.
All right, Ben, well, sorry you've had to go through all of this, but hopefully people see this tonight and feel differently if they were thinking those sorts of things. And we really appreciate your time. It's always wonderful having you on. Thank you.
Thanks, team.
All right, we're off to a break. More Project soon.